If you have some returns or growth rates or just some numbers that are fluctuating quite a bit over time, it might be useful to see what the compound annual growth rate is for this. So there's a couple of different ways of doing that. So let's have a look at a few different functions that you can use to calculate the compound annual growth rate. The options that we'll have a look at are firstly the rate function and then the RRI. Now, with the rate function, if you know that you're going to pay $80,000 up front and you're going to receive $1,500 a month for the next 5 years, we want to work out what that's going to be as an annual return using the rate function. So let's give it a go. So we'll go to rate, the number of periods. Now, the return has been given to us on a monthly basis, so we need to take the 5 years and convert that to monthly. It's going to ask us for what the payment amount is, which is the $1,500, and it's going to ask for the present value or the amount paid up front. That it is asking for it as a negative, it needs to be shown as a negative value, so we need to enter that as a negative amount, and the rest of it you can just leave blank. So that's going to give us the monthly rate of return, and we can just convert that to annual by multiplying it by 12. Let's have a look at the RRI now, which works in a similar way. So the RRI, so if you have present value of 223 and that is going to grow to 327 over a 3 year period, we want to work out what is the implied rate of return of that growth amount. So if we take the number of periods being 3 years, we're just going to leave it as an annual amount here, and the present value is 223, future value is this number here, and that is giving us the implied rate of return. So let's have a look at how to use these two different functions into how to calculate the compound annual growth rate. So let's jump over here. So these are our net income amounts that are changing over time, and we can see that the year-on-year growth has changed quite a lot over the 7 years. Now we can calculate it manually. This is what the formula looks like here. So you can just simply calculate it in Excel like that, or you can use the rate or the RRI function. So a couple of different options there for you. Let's have a look at how the rate function will look. So let's start with that. It might be easier if I use the dialog box. So it's asking us for the number of periods. We can calculate that because we're looking at the difference between 2024 and 2031. So we can see the value is 7. And the payment, we can just, that is nothing. The present value is going to be the starting amount here. And remember that that needs to be negative. So we can just multiply by minus 1. We'll just put a minus in front of it. And the future value is going to be this number here. And the rest of it you can leave blank. So you can see that we get exactly the same result using that. Let's try that again, except this time we'll use the RRI. So the number of periods again is going to be 2031 less there. So that there, the present value is the starting amount and the future value is that number there. Close bracket. There we go. So a couple of different options for calculating the compound annual growth rate.